Oh, yeah, we do have that kind of thing over here in New York. We've got, you know, fun little bar events like Mash Fest, but just haven't found the time to make it out to those.
Oh, man. So now, going into this match the way it was intended on Battlefield, I guess not Miiverse for whatever reason. Corrin and Marth versus two charge characters.
I don't know why that got switched. That was really weird. I had this set up and
then
the name
got a counter off the hoops, but it didn't hit him. He was too low. Oh, Cloud. Oh, no. That's a bad. That there is a bad Cloud. He has some work to do. Stretch is going in right now. I was wondering why Cloud didn't get limit from getting hit so much, because that's the fastest way he can gain limit, but then I remembered they actually increased the cap for said limit gauge. Where, like, from zero, it used to take 6 seconds, now it takes, I think, like, 7 to 8. Which doesn't sound like a lot, but it kind of is.
I mean, man, Frozen has really been taking advantage of the range of that F smash. That was crazy. You saw Frozen spot dodge the Sun Salutation.
He didn't spot dodge. He
searched
it.
Before the Sun Salutation was over. Oh, I thought I saw him spot, like, dodge it first and then do a counter.
Well, no, the counter makes like a dodge animation.
Oh, okay. That was confusing.
Like, it gives him it. Well, let me start the sense over. It's not that animation. It gives him like the intangibility frames that dodging would give you usually, and that's why that turned out.
Yeah, it just looks
that's why
very
it looked
weird.
That way. He tried to stomp him. Tried to use Corrin as a carpet, but not happening today. And he pays for it with the Batwing. Oh boy. Throwing out Smash's Cloud, that's not really apt. Oh no. Yo!
Wow, numbers going all the way.
That was worth it. Yeah, if you're stock up, you can dare someone with Corrin and just send them flying or right down to the doom. Cloud looking to try and even this out as best as he can by taking Marth's second stock there, but they still have work to do. Oh,
right. Numbers and Monster definitely starting to catch up. I almost called him Daigo because of his little tag.
Wait.
Just as I say
there was a weird exchange there, but Numbers is out of his last stock.
Yeah, I think I heard him shout out that he thought he teched, but didn't work.
No, he got hit to the left. Who knows? But game one goes to Frozen and Stretch. I guess now they'll have to reevaluate that.
All right, so they have 5 more games to win because they are in.
That is true. They're on the losers' side, so they have to reset and then come back with the full victory.
We might see one of those long doubles grand final sets, but should be a good set.
It really depends on how they play.
Yeah, I mean, the matches themselves so far are going pretty quick.
Jeez, did you see how far Corrin's uppy sent him? He sent numbers there. That's the thing with Dragon Ascent. It's more useful as a kill move than it is as an actual recovery. Because, yes, it travels some distance, and you can angle it and all that. But the second the attack ends, he drops down like a rock. Mm. Like, it halts all 4 dimensions. You just go straight down, which hurts a lot.
All right, both Stretch and Frozen just coming in with their swords to help their team out whenever needed.
Now, how does Numbers feel being caught in between all these swords? kick. Can he harness the inner Wii Fit and like stretch and yoga his way through, you know, narrowly getting stabbed?
Yeah, random side note. I feel like I want to see more, like, fan art for some of the matches and matchups in this game. You know, like, somebody could make some fan art of, like, Wii Fit, like, clashing her arm with, like, Mars Sword. It would make no sense, but it would be... It makes sense for this game.
What the... Okay, that was a random finishing touch. And... Okay, no one died from it, because that got nerfed in the air. But, ooh, careful. Wow.
All right, so numbers and Monster definitely look like they have that their bearings.
That almost tore his shield apart. If numbers got that force match, that would have snapped it.
Really impressive options from Frozen here, though, because he's using that side B to hit one opponent, and then he's able to turn around and hit the other. So really good for just breaking things up.
I'm not gonna act like I didn't see Stretches get that kill on almost said Daigo. Jeez, this tag on Monster, pardon me.
Man, maybe Daigo plays Smash.
Oh dear.
Both going for a little stab.
Like, no, I got him. No, not close enough. Jeez. This is a game where everyone's just trying to break each other's shields. I'm wondering why. Ooh. Oh, there he goes.
Stretch waiting a little bit too long for that up B. Yeah, I'm actually wondering if we're going to see that a lot more in the Smash meta as Smash 4 keeps developing. You know, people are learning a lot more setups for breaking shields, things along those lines.
Which is always good, because when it happens, it often is hilarious.
Yeah, whenever somebody actually gets a shield break and they completely flub their punish, though, I cringe.
Mm-mm. I've had it happen.
And that's more of a thing in 1v1s.
Now, up smash, Korn's up smash just went through Cloud's dare. Well, I don't know if it went through or if the attack had ended and he was putting the sword back. Oh my god.
Ooh, really nice from Stretch. Saved his teammate there.
I'm surprised it did not kill. But that would have been awful if he just died by hoops.
Yeah, it was worth going for. Worst case scenario, he was going to die anyways, but he saved him for that extra little moment. All right, so this is looking like it's pretty much going to be game two for the red team. I mean, you know, never speak too soon.
Whoa,
but
that was close.
Personally, I think if I was numbers right now, I think this is the situation where you want to go, okay, so this round we probably lost, but he needs to figure out what they're going to do in the next round and, you know, sort of get his bearings against them in the neutral during this 2v1 situation.
That was crisp. That was like the perfect angle for him to get caught by the up smash, or up air, and went slice.
I lost because...
What?
I lost, but... Before game one, what was gonna be game one, I started my game.
Are they running it back?
All my buttons had been mapped to special. I had to drop out and reset my controls.
Yeah, I heard about that.
And
I would say
it's totally fucking up. I want to run
that. Talk to the TO desk. Talk to the TO people.
Sorry about that little discrepancy. Game three, going to Town and City. This was the blue team's counterpick. I'm wondering what they're...
Wow! Ooh, really early kill.
Maybe that's what they were trying to do. But what I was going to say was, what are they planning to do in regards to the...
Wow, did you just see Cloud's down smash clashing with a Wii Fit Sun Salutation? Very lucky for Monster there.
No, did it really?
And then again, I say lucky. Like, you never know if something was on purpose, but there's no way he could have.
Cloud's aerials are weird in that, like, you know, when he attacks and swings and all that. When the blade is green, or the tip or the edge or what have you, when it's green like that, it clashes with a lot, and it beats out most physical moves. Wow! I thought the stun from the Fang shot would have ended before Stretch could capitalize, but that showed me up.
Ah. Frozen got Stretch with the tipper of.
Korn's up air, while nerfed, is still very potent.
And he hit Monster at the same time, too, but it cost him his teammate stock.
Mm-hmm.
And what sucks for him is I don't think whoever he hit on the blue team even got hit by the tipper, but his teammate got hit by the tipper just because of the positioning.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. I tell you, some of the most tense moments in this game are when someone's charging smash attacks and, like, they're stuck, like, oh, wait, what do I do? Do I panic? Do I do the obvious and get hit? Or do you keep your cool and capitalize? Because I think something that quite a few players forget is that if you're charging a smash attack and you get hit by something, you take more knockback. You're sent further than if the hit you, like if you were just standing.
No, actually, I didn't even realize that.
I'm not sure, like, did Korn just, like, swing around, kick the other way, and get hit by the Sun Salutation?
Yeah, it was right before Korn was about to land.
Well, I mean, that's a panic reaction, but you could have just jumped. Or, yeah, he was pinned. He was pinned, so he could have just jumped over it.
I mean, that's the one thing, is Korin, I feel like in 1v1s...
Did he just get... Oh, he got gimped. Wow. He got booped.
I feel like Korin in 1v1s, her side B is amazing in 1v1s. It's super safe. In a 2v2, though, like when you see somebody do what Korin just did to numbers, she's going to be vulnerable while she's landing. I'm pretty sure there's nothing Korin can do before she lands, right?
The instant pin, or when you're pinned to the ground in general... Like, it's good. You can do a number of things, especially if you pin someone. Like, I've been, like, two people, both my opponents, in a doubles match, and killed them that way. However, when you're pinned, like, the spire that's in the ground extends Korn's hurtbox, so they can hit that, and she'll take damage.
Yeah, from what I'm seeing right now, though, if Korin does that side move after the pin... and she's going to land on stage, there's nothing she can do afterwards. Like, right there.
Oh, yeah, I mean...
Luckily, it is low lag once she lands, but...
Yeah, it's... Exactly. The lag isn't that bad where it's like, oh, God, I'm vulnerable. What do?
Yeah, you could definitely catch her during landing in doubles, though.
Woo! I'm wondering what Frozen meant to do out of that. Because that didn't seem like the right option.
All right, so number is going to hold on to both these
stocks. Back throw. Ooh. Okay, never mind. I was about to say, up throw would have killed her at that percent.
All right, so Monster and Numbers are going to bring this up and take at least one game in this first set. So who knows? They could end it right now and win these next two games, or Frozen and Stretch. All they need is one more win.
Reverse,
and then
the reverse 3-0. Or, well, I say 3-0, but, you know.
Yeah, well, we know what you mean.
Looks like we are going to... It's red team's pick now. What would serve them best?
Yeah, Numbers, I think, is definitely showing us how to do some edge guarding against both Marth and Korin. I feel like those are two characters that are pretty vulnerable during their recoveries, but because they have hitboxes on their recoveries and because Korin has that little bit of, I think it's super armor or invincibility, people are afraid to challenge it. But despite those things, both those recoveries are very challengeable. I mean, maybe not the most punishable recovery, but if you have, like, a disjoint move, it's worth going for.
I was going to say, Korin's recovery isn't really invincible or anything. It just has, splashing hitboxes because of the water.
Okay, I thought somebody said it had invincibility frames for, like, the startup or something like that.
To my knowledge, yeah,
maybe.
No.
Alright, so Stretch and Frozen seem to have a little bit of control in this match. Whoa. So far, but very even percents right now. I can't believe I just saw Corrin beat out Cloud's down air. I know Corrin's range is great, but I'm just so not used to seeing Cloud's down air get beat by anything. Such a big hitbox.
Take convenient things about this character. Oh man, I thought Cloud was gonna make it. Good down smash for the coverage.
All right, Monster's got that limit break charged up. And don't know how that whiffed, but Woo! Stretch was able to get away from that. And Stretch and Frozen, I mean, keeping this pretty even. And we've already seen before, Stretch is pretty good at staying alive when he's at really high percent. Oh, but commentator's curse right there. Stretch gets taken out. And I mean, you could say the same thing about Numbers, so it's not going to surprise me if Numbers is able to hold on to this first stock for a while. Ooh. Cloud's down tilt went right under Corrin's F smash.
Just throwing in the down air for assurance there. A little extra damage with the Sensei. Did you see that?
I'm telling you, you'd be surprised.
Ducked right under that. I mean, I know Weeflet's crouch is like one of the lowest in the game, but when it's actually used to escape stuff, it's funny to me.
Yeah, it could definitely surprise you still. A lot of stuff you just won't expect her to be able to go under.
Well, I mean, it's Weeflet.
Man, speaking
look how low she went for the down smash. Ooh, nice. Oh, no, that's not going to kill. I thought he had rage.
Yeah, you know Numbers wanted to get that little follow-up with the Sun Salutation. It would have been amazing if he pulled it off.
You know, what he hasn't been going for, that he loves doing in singles at least anyway, is like anticipating where the opponent's going to be and then using the header move, Weeflet side B, to like dunk them down. He hasn't been going for that.
Right, Numbers helping the blue team take that little bit of a lead right now. I don't know, I really thought Frozen and Stretch were going to at least bring this to the second set, but the way the blue team's momentum is looking right now, Monster and Numbers could just win this round and the next one. It would not surprise me, because it definitely feels like they have the momentum right now.
I mean, if they play smart and they get a good groove, rhythm going, then yeah, most certainly they'll... Like, they'll really feel themselves. Yeah. They see, like, okay, this is what this character's going to do. This is what I'm going to do to beat that out.
Right now, it feels like...
If you play enough matches against someone and you're analytical, or you just, you know, learn things, then you'll pick up on it.
Yeah, like, right now, Numbers and Monster are basically using, like, the same strategy that we've seen Woo! Them do a lot today, of having Cloud just kind of hang back, charge things, and then Numbers is kind of going into the front lines. But I guess they're just using it a little bit more effectively right now.
There's that pin that everybody loves. Ouch. Ooh, not this time.
I'm surprised how safe Weeflet's forward throw was.
Oh, so close. Oh, he's living.
All right, Stretch still living. Now, this is a pretty tense situation, because even though this is a 2v1, it's definitely very possible
it's
for Numbers,
Numbers
to make it back.
He's done crazier things in 2v1s. Oh.
All right, so that's going to bring Numbers to his last stock.
But he's still, you know, he's fresh. So look at that.
Yeah, I really want to see like what kind of strategy Stretch and Frozen are going to go for. Okay, trying to sandwich numbers a little bit. Numbers just playing very safe, very evasive.
And there that goes. Sure enough. Game four goes to Monster Numbers. It is now tied up. If Frozen and Stretch take this next game, it'll be reset. But if not, that'll be it. It'll be going home in second. And we are going back to Battlefield. This was the red team's decision. That's probably to their benefit, just because I don't know if you've seen it, but Corrin can I forget what the community for Corrin dubbed it as, but there's this thing where off a platform she can cancel her falling momentum with the pin, the hop for the dragon lunge. Like I myself can't do it consistently, but you know, when people get it off to work, it works. And I don't think this patch is, you know, limited that or taking away that utility. Caught him going up.
All right, so red team is able to take out Cloud pretty early. Stretch and Frozen just need to keep this momentum going.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. See, that's what I was talking about earlier. If you want to, you know, trump someone at the ledge's Corrin, the best option is to run up to good cross slash.
I feel like no matter what character you're using, a lot of times you don't want to just like commit to a smash. I mean, people are gonna do it anyways.
Oh no,
but
is that it?
Ooh.
Oh, he's
living. Okay, numbers and monster definitely still living.
They're just bringing each other up. Elevator of pain. They mean well, but how much damage can they take?
Yeah, no, nice awareness on that part.
But what I was going to say, like I previously mentioned, the best thing for Corrin at the ledge, or I guess an opponent hanging from the ledge, is to run up, turn around, and charge the forward smash. The only thing they can do is... The only thing they can do is just hang there, honestly. Because it beats out all get-up options. What the oh, I'm sorry, yeah. There were like two or three red flashes at once, so it just like obscured everything.
Well, I was looking at numbers and
all,
Frozen.
All I know is both members of the blue team are now down one more stock.
Yeah, and Frozen looks like he didn't even, it looks like Frozen didn't even tilt Corrin's F smash downwards, but even the Corrin's F smash going straight in front of him is actually able to hit numbers while he's doing his crouch and down tilt.
Really?
So range of that F smash is definitely pretty good. You definitely cannot crouch under Corrin's F smash if it's pointed in the middle.
I'll have to see that for myself later. Never just throwing out suns of all sizes.
Yeah, red team is looking really strong right now, though.
Whew, he lived. Wait, hold on, Frozen still has all of his stocks?
Yep, that's what I said. Red team is looking really strong right now. I think we are about to see this bracket reset. And wow, up throw still not killing Corrin. Corrin definitely not being the lightest character. We're seeing that right now.
Not the lightest, but come on.
Well, I mean, hey, I thought up throw.
Damn,
I thought Wii Fit's up throw would have killed Corrin at that percent too. Like, you know, it's not Wii Fit's strongest move, but it does kill.
I mean, 176, come on.
Yeah, I think he was at 140 when he got up thrown by Wii Fit, and it still wasn't enough.
Mm-mm. I was going to say, I mean, numbers can, again, once again, bring it back, but against four stocks now.
Yeah, I think red team has pretty much
that
got this in the bag.
Too much? Oh, Dragon Ascent. He lost a stock, but that was his first stock, so he's still golden. I'm not sure why he's throwing. Wow, they're just, are you seeing this right now? They're just going up and up and up and up.
Numbers and Monster are probably like, man, we could have closed this out. Just want to go play singles.
What? Oh, killed his partner. But it's okay. Maybe.
Yeah, Stretch is going to take that stock right away, make it a nice 2v1 situation just to ensure that they can seal out game three of this first set.
Right, right. Damn. Oh!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was not a tipper up air from Korin.
Well, Korin's up air doesn't really have a tip, but it's still stupidly strong. If that was pre-patch, that would have
sure? I thought, from what I understood...
No, the only moves of Korin's that have tippers or anything that, like, transforms Korin's limbs into, like, the spire from the actual dragon.
I don't know. When Korin first came out, I was sure that
the sword
she had a tip
the sword
her
itself,
aerials.
The sword itself does not have a tip.
We sure might have to double check that loop.
Ouch.
All right,
but
so that.
But now it is a reset. We're here for the long haul, ladies and gentlemen.
We're yeah, that is going
to
be a nice game from
like
Stretch and Frozen.
We're going into what I like to call true grand finals now. Alright, so they're getting right back into it. No rest for the wary. And they're deciding to go to... What was that, Smashville?
Yep. Sometimes I can't tell at first if it's Smashville or Town and City, but
because
it's Smashville.
Because they look the same and they sound the same and oh. It's like, why aren't more stages from other franchises made to be legal?
If only, but you know.
Wow!
Just so
ended him prematurely.
Blue
not
team definitely starting
in.
Off the second set really strong.
It's like, oh, okay, you got some cool stuff on me before, but now it's go time.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, though, don't forget, if this was Town and City, you would see an actual city behind them, but you don't see that on Smashville. You just
implying
see little,
that's not a city?
A little village. I don't know. You know, there's
yeah,
more like
say,
big
if
buildings.
Not, if it's not
town
a town or a city, what is that in the background? But
it's like it's a village
or
something.
Yeah, you just answered
know.
It for me. It's a vill. It's a village.
All right. So Monster just making his way back towards safety. I'm surprised I haven't seen him use this limit break a little bit earlier though, and then he was forced to use it recovering.
Frozen is, like, enamored with the counter surge. I mean, I love that move, but I don't use it that much.
And I think he's been using it in pretty safe situations just for edge guarding, again, because both these characters are going to have hitboxes when they're trying to come back to the stage. But I haven't really seen him throw it out in the neutral, which is very good, because if he was getting used to just throwing out that counter in the neutral, it would definitely be very
punishable. Oh, there he goes.
Ooh, a shield break from offstage. Amazing
wow.
By Stretch, but unfortunately...
He's alive.
Yeah, Monster was able to get out. I think, did Numbers hit him out of it? I don't know, somebody hit him out of it.
something else. Oh, nice. I like what he was going for with the Blade Beam. I mean, Counter Surge made it pass through him.
Yeah, beautiful patience from Stretch there. I think Numbers was expecting him to just go and try to get like
actually,
a little fair or something.
Actually, that's interesting. The Blade Beam is, Limit Break Blade Beam is transcendent, I know, but on Korin's counter it went through? Because if that was used against Marv's counter, he would hit, but then still get hit by, like, you know, the blasts and whatnot. But no, for Korin, it just went right through.
I say a lot of chaos happening in this game. Stocks are dropping left and right. I like this.
Good save from Numbers. Man, people just love grabbing that left ledge. Smash to the left. Mm. Easy does it. Ah, missed opportunity.
Right, so things looking very even right now, but it's just going to take a little bit to take care of numbers. So if red team can manage that, it's going to be very good for them.
Oh, good. Good mention by Noob Warrior 523 in the chat, saying that Korin's counter surge. I didn't know this. The ISAA frames, which is, I think it stands for like interruptible as soon as. Those for Korin's counter surge, it's one frame, which is pretty ridiculous. Good on you. Oh, but the pin, the tip of the pin. It took numbers his last stock, and now Monster's by himself. What will he do? He gonna die. That's what he gonna do.
I have to admit,
do or die. That was like 3 weeks ago, right?
So wow, really nice stuff from Frozen and Stretch. I have to admit, I kind of expected once like Monster numbers started catching up in that first set, I was like, okay, they have the momentum, and it looks like they're kind of figuring out what Frozen and Stretch are doing. But
yeah.
Frozen and Stretch are keeping their momentum going, so they might actually take this grand final set.
Well, and, I mean, it's been going back and forth, so
this
who knows what shenanigans will come forth and ruin their day.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but if Stretch is able to win this, this might actually be a first-time doubles win for him. Definitely not a first-time top three doubles win for him, but a first-time, like, you know, winning grand finals, actually getting first. Mm-hmm. I think that would be the first for Stretch.
I mean, by all means, good luck to him. Good luck to all the players. They're doing their damnedest. I mean, I haven't really seen many flubs, like, you know, accidentally hitting partners and whatnot.
And despite how strong Marth has proven to be,
ooh,
you really don't see...
Wait, what did he... Oh, he hit Marth.
And despite how strong Marth seems to be, you really don't see too many Marth players out there. So I'm sure a lot
I
of people
mean,
really
are,
appreciate that Stretch is out here representing.
Okay, but can we please get more of... Can we please get more of Lucina?
Yeah, definitely. I know, like, one Lucina player who goes to NYU.
I am that guy. I do love Awakening and Fates. I actually have on my jacket a keychain of Prince Xander from Nor.
Yeah, speaking of Lucina, just for a moment, I will say, since you brought it up, a lot of people really underestimate Lucina, too. They just say, oh, it's a worse version of Marth, but Lucina has a few little advantages.
Well, the thing with Lucina is that, unlike Marth, she doesn't have a tip.
Yeah.
Which doesn't sound like a lot, but, you know. No, no, don't worry, Noob Warrior. I have the Osric keychain, too. I just decided to go with Xander today. Good bite from Frozen there to get back into the match. I love the bite from that attack. It's so vicious.
It surprised me so much the first time I ever started dealing with
numbers with the forward smash.
Yeah,
well intentioned, but he kills his partner instead.
Ooh. Yeah, this is once again looking pretty good for the red team.
Oh man,
I was gonna say when Korn
steals down a stock.
I was gonna say when Korn was first released. I had no idea about that chomp. Like, in all the trailers and whatnot, I didn't notice it, so it definitely caught me really off guard.
Oh, no. This isn't Dreamland. You don't get pineappled like that.
Yeah, I really don't know what happened there. I guess maybe he was DI'ing a little bit too much inwards towards the stage.
I don't know. It sucks, though.
Yeah, so red team kind of running away with this one.
Once again, it's numbers against four. Four stocks, that is. What will he do? Whoa, dear. I think Numbers is the only way, WeFit is the only character that can get away with something like that. Being trapped in between two players on an opposing team and having a move that hits both of them on both sides really quickly.
Yeah, I love how, I don't know if you caught just a moment ago, Stretch, like, did not respect Sun Salutation whatsoever. He just ran in there, forward aired, clashed with the Sun Salutation, and hit Numbers at the same time.
Well, if it wasn't fully charged, then yeah, it eats through.
Ooh.
Damn.
really smart stuff from Stretch. That was 48%. You saw that, right? 48%.
Because tips, man. I mean,
numbers. Charged it all the way.
Numbers had the right idea, but his timing was just like 1 second off.
Yeah, and Numbers isn't the kind of player that you just like scare into dodging. So impressive that he managed to pull that off.
I'm sure he was going to throw something out after the dodge if that was successful, but it happens. So Frozen Stretch looking like they're trying to get away with a 3-0 after the reset. And this may or may not be settled once and for all on Town and City. Almost hit Smashville. Jesus. These stages. Oh, wait, he went choke. Huh.
Ooh, I am really glad to see that. Honestly, I've been wanting to see Numbers of Shulk like ever since he dropped him. I still think Shulk has a lot of potential in this game.
No, he's much better now because like three or four patches ago, all of, like the end lag on all of his aerials got like cut in half practically. So like if you're a character that has to like get in close for physical hits and whatnot, what Shulk can do is just like throw out an air over and over again, and you can't get close.
Yeah, I personally still struggle a lot against Shulk players that really know what they're doing, but I think like part of that is because I don't play any characters that can deal with his range.
Korn has like the most range out of any character because those forward smashes. But like before that particular patch, I used to beat Shulk all the time. Now he scares me. But who knows? Maybe this this might be beneficial to them.
So these guys going for blow right now.
Ooh.
He really went for that.
What? Oh, backslash.
So much chaos.
That was that was actually hilarious.
To say props to both these teams for managing to like actually understand everything that's going on in this chaos. I know when I'm playing and we have like some of these chaotic moments, it can really throw you off sometimes.
Woo.
Oh, wow, nice perfect shield from Numbers there. Avoided that shield break.
Wow. Careful.
Ooh.
I wonder why, like, I know...
That could be part of the reason that Numbers switched to Shulk. You might have wanted to have that counter ready.
Yeah, I suppose. I was going to say...
Ooh, and there we see it again.
I was wondering why he didn't just go with the normal counter as opposed to hitting him backwards on that last one. But oh, no!
Wow, I can't believe I'm seeing like red team take the lead again because the Shulk pick looked like it was working out for Numbers in some ways. I think Shulk
that's his game for you. I mean, one thing it looks like it's one-sided for 1 second, and then one thing happens in like 2 seconds, and suddenly the favors have been turned.
Yeah, Shulk with this range though, and the Monado arts, not the worst character to have in a 2v1 situation.
You don't want to be in jump mode and be getting hit because that's it.
Ooh.
One of the drawbacks of staying in jump mode, you take more knockback from hits. Same with Buster in Smash mode, honestly.
So, nice play by both.